playing Matthew's brother?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you feel like Matthew's brother? You guys get along? Like,
actually, Matthew and I have a lot of similarities in our upbringing and whatnot. He grew up in Houston. I spent a lot of time when I was a kid. He grew up in Austin, I'm sorry. I spent a lot of time in Houston as a kid.
Okay.
My dad worked for Exxon at the time. So when we met, it was he felt like kin. We got along. Yeah, we got along very well. And when you're with somebody from where you grew up, like Texas, where an accent's there, it comes out even more when you're together. So, you know, just at the screen test, when I first met him, he's like, "How you doing?" I'm like, "I'm good." And it was just like, "Oh God,
the accent comes out more."
Mocking him, yeah. So, yeah.
So what do you think about the twist in this, the ghosts that come back? This is something different for a romantic comedy, having that kind of a twist.
I think it's a fun twist on the romantic comedy formula. I think Lucas and Moore did a real neat twist on it. And it's fun to go back, and the idea that you can go back and see what a jerk you were or what a sweetheart you were, I think it would help a lot of people.
Okay, now wait a minute. So if a girlfriend came back to haunt you, would she be telling you that you were a big jerk growing up, or would she be saying?
If a girl came back to haunt me, first of all, I'd be very sad that she was dead, because obviously she's dead. But I'd wonder how she died. I hope I had nothing to do with it, because I got some skeletons. But if she came back, people have been asking about the worst breakups and stuff like that. And I think I topped it, by the way. Mine may be the worst breakup story in the history of the world. But I think it's R-rated. I can't really give it. It's so R-rated. It's okay to do R-rated on About.com? All right. Okay, here's the thing. If you ever catch your present girlfriend at a sex shop with her two ex-boyfriends and they're testing massagers, she's not the right girl for you. Don't bring her home to mom.
Do you have any clue?
She's the devil.
Did you have a clue about this relationship?
She was the devil until I caught her at a sex shop with her two ex-boyfriends. News at 11. Breckin dates whores.
Actually, it'd be better for you to go back and be the ghost in a relationship.
I'd love to go back and be the ghost and go, "You suck. You're a terrible person. You're an awful individual."
Everybody keeps telling me that Mark Waters is the best director in the world. Okay, why? What sets him apart?
A lot of directors have a lot of energy, which is fantastic, and then a lot of directors have, you know, hours and hours worth of preparation. They know exactly what they want, and Mark is all of them. Mark is 3 o'clock. I mean, movie shoots are a lot of fun, and they do get long. It's 3 a.m. You're in makeup, which feels weird if you're not used to wearing makeup all day long. And to look over and Mark is out of his director chair, hopping around, ready to go, loving what he does, it's contagious. It's absolutely infectious.
And he had pink.
Really good swine flu. Mark Waters is the best version of swine flu. So to have him be so upbeat and loving his work, and he loves working with actors, he's just great. He really is just fantastic. I met him years and years and years ago on other projects, and I've just always enjoyed him. He's fantastic. I was so glad I got to work with him.
Now, did you participate in his ping pong tournaments? Because he said he had them.
No, I did not participate. I don't.
Why?
Like,
you know what? Nobody does. So who did he play against?
I'm over ping pong.
But he loves
key parties are what I'm into now. Heavy key parties.
Nice.
No, I'm kidding.
What do you have next?
What do I have next?
Besides a key party to get to.
Yeah, I was about to say, I'm so bad at this. I'm doing a new show, writing and producing and actually starring in a new show with my partner, Ryan Phillippe. So, we're doing that. Can't really say the name of it or the network yet, sorry to say.
Great, or a synopsis or anything.
No, I have that awesome time where it's maybe 2 days where I actually can't say it.
Nice.
Look at that.
What if I talk to you in 2 days?
Maybe I'm in the next Twilight. Maybe I'm the next Batman. You don't know.